What should carriers do right now in order to become ready for the 5G?
So the 5G network is going to be very different from what we're traditionally seeing in the 3G and 4G networks. It's going to be a software-defined network with REST-based interfaces in a service-based architecture in the core network that integrates the different functions within the core network. And so given these differences, carriers need to be thinking more as software-based architectures that are different from the point-to-point integrations that were used in the core network previously. And so thinking along the lines of continuous integration and continuous development in their software, in the development of their software functions, looking at agile software methodologies so that they can update the network more easily and more frequently to bring innovative services to market. And then also, in order to enable some of the 5G promised use cases, to be able to have APIs that expose the core network functions to external partners to enable them to monetize the network as it's deployed. Those would be the three main things, I think, for carriers to consider.
And regarding BSS and OSS, are there any transformation or large impact for carriers on this journey to 5G?
I wouldn't say that there was a large impact, but there is certainly going to be more real-time and dynamic integration between the BSS and the network. So for improved customer engagement, you're going to see more information being drawn from the network into the BSS, and then customer responses going back into the network as part of the dynamic integration for real-time customer engagement. And also, as I mentioned, with the partner services, there's going to be real-time requests coming in from partners for network resources to drive their services, and then information from the network being used for analytics to improve those services and as part of an automated feedback loop in this new software-defined network.
From what you're saying, I guess IT and networks will be even more integrated. So what is your advice for carriers?
In the current generation of the standards, the initial deployments will be with the 5G new radio network integrating with the EPC. So the core network will still be largely the 4G functions. But I think what carriers need to do is, like I mentioned earlier, start thinking along the lines of what they need to have in place for the future software-defined network, and start changing the culture of their organizations and the way they do things internally to prepare for that day when the network will be completely software-based. They will require much heavier automation and analytics to drive and manage the network once it's completely software-driven.
And talking about the framework from implementing 5G, what's the journey in the US and what can we expect from it?
So today, much of the focus on the initial deployments in the US has been around fixed wireless, so extending wireless coverage to areas that perhaps don't have a good broadband service. And that's largely a function of where carriers are, where the standards are, and what devices are available today. I think as more and more consumer devices become available, you'll start to see an evolution of services and devices available that consumers can see the difference and be able to reap the benefits of what the 5G networks have to offer. And then I think looking even further ahead, what we'll start to see is some of the more novel use cases around augmented reality, virtual reality, telemedicine, and things like that, that will become possible once the network is well established and carriers have a good understanding of how to manage the network actively in the new deployments.